Hi there, this is Vadim Michalenko, and in this quick video we're going to look at the VLOOKUP formula in Microsoft Excel. We'll start with the quick overview of the formula, and then we'll look at a lot of examples, so stay here with me on this channel.
Let's start with the quick example. In this example, we need to find order amount based on the known order ID, and we have a table of existing orders. To do this, we will type equals VLOOKUP and then provide four values. First value is the known value that we're searching for. In our case, this is cell A7 with the order ID number 839293. Second value is the range in which we will be searching. Third value is the column index for the column that we need. And in our case, this is column D, which contains amount. But numerically, this is column number 4, because order ID is column number 1, name is column number 2, email is 3, and then amount is column number 4. And then we'll provide the last value, false, for exact match. Once we finalize the formula, you see that the value found is $423.38. And as you can see, this is the amount for the order 839293.
The VLOOKUP function in Excel performs a vertical lookup by searching for a value in the first column of the table and returning the value in the same row based on the index number position. For example, if your table contains list of orders, you can find customer name, email, amount, ship date, or other available attributes of the order based on the known order ID. For example, if your order ID is 839287, you can run lookup to find customer name, which would be Ivana Weber, or email, which would be Ivana Weber at tridenta.com, or find the order amount in the amount of $406.92, which was shipped on September 7th, 2018.
And now let's see how well you mastered the material. We're going to do a quick quiz, so stay here with me. Question: what is the most important object in Microsoft Excel for Weight Watchers? You're right. Pie chart. Well, you got it right.
To add VLOOKUP function, you need to navigate to Formulas tab and then click on an Insert Function button. Then you type VLOOKUP and find the formula. There are four values we need to provide. Lookup value is the known value we'll be searching for. Table array is the area which we'll be searching. Lookup index number is the index of the column which will be returned that contains the value we're looking for. And then range specifies the way we will be searching. False indicates exact match, and true would be not exact match. We will be using false. Let's add VLOOKUP formula using this functions arguments dialog box. For the lookup value, we'll provide A7. For table array, we will select the range between A2 and E51. For the column index number, since we're looking for amount, we'll select 4. And for range lookup, we'll select false for exact match. And you can see that we've selected order 839293, and the amount for this order is $423.38.
Now, let's look at how to use VLOOKUP formula to find other attributes of the order.
VLOOKUP formula in Microsoft Excel helps you find specific value based on the one known value. For example, we're looking at the list of orders in this table. We have order ID, name, email, amount, and ship date. In our business case, is we need to find customer email based on the specific order number, or we need to find order amount based on the specific order number. Using VLOOKUP formula, we can supply order ID and find any of the remaining attributes here listed here in this table.
This is the syntax of VLOOKUP formula. You need to supply known value, in our case it would be order ID, then you need to supply range for searching, and you need to identify that. Then you need to specify the column we are searching for, because different column represents different value. And then you need to define the match type. How exactly are you going to match the value? Now, as we know the syntax, let's use VLOOKUP formula to find email address of the customer for the order 839284. To do that, I'm going to type VLOOKUP, then the order ID 839284. Then I need to identify the range of the cells where I will be searching for the information, and the ranges between the cells of A2 to E23. Then I would need to specify the email column in this range, and the email column is number 3, because the first one is order ID, second one is the name, and the third one is the email. And then I need to specify the type of match. True is an approximate match, and false is the exact match. So I'm going to use false for exact match.
If you're interested to learn more about Microsoft Excel, I recommend training course on Udemy. Just navigate to howtoanalyzedata.net/excel to learn more. I've carefully selected this course, and you get substantial discount from the retail price. Just to let you know, this is an affiliate link, and I get small commission if you make the order. Don't make purchases, though, if you don't need it, but thank you for your consideration and support of this channel.
Based on the information I provided, system found email for Catherine Moffitt. Let's look at how VLOOKUP can help us solve specific business problems. For example, how can you find customer name or email based on specific order number? Or how can you find order amount based on order number? Or how can you find ship date? First, let's look at name and email. VLOOKUP can only return one value, so we would need to do name first and then email. As I started typing, please pay attention that instead of putting specific order number, I put in the cell reference, which is A6 in this case. And we'll see how this will impact copying and pasting of VLOOKUP formula in solving later business problems. We supplied order number by putting the reference to A6 cell, then we specified the range, and then we specify the column ID for where the information should be taken from. And the last step is we specify how we're going to match the data. We picked an exact match by supplying the value false, and the name of Aliyah Reeve has been returned by VLOOKUP, which is the exact correct value.
And now, let's look at what happens when you copy and paste VLOOKUP formula in Microsoft Excel.
As I have already mentioned, we used reference cell instead of supplying the exact order ID number. So we reference cell A6 in our previous example. Now let's see how copying and pasting of the data in VLOOKUP formula impacts the values. So when I copied and pasted it, I see a different match being found. So let's understand why is this happening. If we look closely into the formula of the pasted value, instead of pointing to the cell A6, now it points to cell A10, because we shifted the formula by 3 rows. So 6 plus 4 would be equal to 10, and that's the reason it points to a different cell. And as you can see, the new value for the order ID that we're searching in VLOOKUP is 839302. If this is what we want, that's fine, but in our case, we want to point back and search for the order ID number 839290. Because this is the customer email for that order we're trying to find. There are multiple ways to change, and then this is exactly what we're gonna do next. But the important thing is to understand when we copy and paste formulas, that's what happens with referential integrity. Once we change that, we also need to change the column ID where we will be finding the value. And now, instead of 2, the ID will be 3, because this is the third column that points to email. Now let's go ahead and do it and change the formula after copy and paste.
First, let's change the order ID that we are referencing. And as you can see, now it points to the customer name, since we just copied and pasted the formula, and it still points to column 2 instead of column 3. But now let's change column 2 to column 3 to point to customer email. And we see the correct results returned back by VLOOKUP formula, which is customer email aliyahreeve@antifocal.com. Let's continue and see how we can find order amount based on a specific order number. To do that, I'm going to copy and paste the formula and modify the fields so it calculates exactly what we're looking for. Once I completed copy and paste, you can see formula cannot calculate and find the required value. And the reason for that is because range is shifted and it cannot determine what is the right value. To correct this, I'm going to modify the range and start selection from the cell A2. As you can see, once I corrected the range, it points to the same value as the previous formula that we had in the cell G9, which is email, and it returns email aliyahreeve@antifocal.com. Now my goal is to modify the input parameter in VLOOKUP formula so it points to amount column. And the amount column is column number 4. And as you can see, once I change the input parameter to 4, now it points to the amount. Let's continue and do the last step in our exercises and try to find the ship date based on the order number. To do that, I'm going to copy and paste formula again. I'm going to modify the range. And as you can see, once I did this, it points to the amount because this was copy and paste of the formula. And then the last step is to point to column number 5. And as you can see, the interesting thing happens, even though we point to column number 5, we do not see the date, but we see the 5-digit number. But the reality is, this is how Excel stores the dates using those 5-digit numbers. So the only thing we need to do is to change the formatting of this number. To do this, I'm going to select the cell and go into the drop-down that has the formatting and select the different data type, and I'm going to select the short date. And as you can see, once I selected the short date, it shows the correct date for that specific order number.
Have you enjoyed this episode? Make sure to subscribe so you will not miss the next one, and tell your friends about it. You can find links and downloads in the description section of this video. There are a lot of helpful links and a lot of other helpful information you will benefit from.
Make sure to check out my other relevant videos and subscribe to my YouTube channel. We have a lot of great stuff planned in the pipeline, and I don't want you to miss any of it. And if you'd like to get notified about all the new stuff that are coming out, make sure to subscribe to my email list as well. All links are here on the screen. Make sure to click to stay in touch. Thanks again for watching.